So I've been interested in the friction on faults during earthquakes. What are the resistant forces that prevent earthquakes from getting very big, very large? And so one of the ways that you can get to it is by measuring the frictional heat on a fault, measuring how much heat it produces. That's related to how much it slips and how much resistant stress was on it, how much breaks it had during rupture. And so to really get that answer, you had to drill across the fault after an earthquake. One of the things, one of the main reasons why we built these types of systems after the big earthquake was to measure the little bit of increase in temperature across the fault that was caused by shearing, by the earthquake itself, by the frictional resistance, just like moving your hands together creates heat. We were able to observe that with the JFAST data. But one of the things we also saw was this hydrology. As earthquakes happen, aftershocks happen, fluids would go through. And I really like to know about the fluids, because when fluid pressure builds up, it can cause the fault to get weaker, maybe cause it to deform, maybe slip a little bit easier. So our sensors themselves have essentially a thermometer in them that is connected to a data logger. They're going to record every, you know, few seconds over time, potentially for years. But they're all encased in titanium metal casings because of the huge pressures at 7-8 kilometers down underwater. They each have a battery. They look like a AA battery, but they're a type of lithium battery that can allow us to record for long periods of time and then perhaps leave them there for many years, kind of see how the subduction zone evolves over the next 10 or 12 years. The first thing we do is we go down with a big tube. That essentially creates some sort of hole that stays open. Then we go down with a drill bit. We drill down across the fault, 950 meters below the seafloor. We now have a hole, we bring the drill bit back up. Now we build the observatory. The observatory is largely a steel tube that we're going to install down into that hole that we just drilled. And then inside that steel tube, we have heavy weight at the end of a rope, and we've got our sensors attached to it. And then we lower it down to the seafloor, try to thread the needle one more time, put it in there, detach, and we go away.
They're proposing to shrink wrap this.
A lot of the things that we're seeing on board now, those things are directly related to the same problems that I'm interested in. And it's all integrative. And so the things that we see in chemistry also tell us some things about the hydrology. Things we see in the structural geology, the faults and fractures, those things relate to this stuff.
And then I wonder if that stuff at the bottom is kind of more like this.
So hopefully, I think some of the things that we're trying to see with the observatory, some of the things we see there may be able to contribute and kind of make a more integrative understanding of the subduction zone.